interpreter. Tell everybody. Everybody. This is my war beat. Says it's a war beat.
Why do you insist on being called Muhammad Ali now?
Well, that's the name given to me by my leading teacher, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. That's my original name. That's a black man name. Cassius Clay was my slave name. I'm no longer a slave.
What does it mean?
Muhammad means worthy of all praises, and Ali means most high.
You want to say Cassius Clay when Howard Cosell and everybody is calling you Muhammad Ali? Now, why you got to be one of all people who's color to keep saying Cassius Clay?
Howard Cosell is not the one who's going to fight you. I
am. It's really hard on yourself now. In the sport angle. Why don't you call me my name, man?
Well, what's your name? You told me your name was Cassius Clay a few
years
ago.
I never told you my name was Cassius Clay. My name is Muhammad Ali, and you will announce it right there in the center of that ring after the fight if you don't do it now.
For the benefit of the broadcast, him. All right?
You acting just like an old Uncle Tom. Another Floyd Patterson. I'm gonna punish you.
You ain't got no
back off.
My conscience won't let me go shoot my brother or some darker people or some poor hungry people in the mud for big powerful America and shoot them for what? They never called me nigger. They never lynched me. They never put no dogs on me. They never robbed me of my nationality, raped and killed my mother and father. Well, I'm going to shoot them for what? How can I go shoot them? Them little poor little black people, little babies and children and women. How can I shoot them poor people? Just take me to jail.
Ali more than held his own against students who had a far better formal education than he.
I'm saying you're talking about me about some draft, and all of you white boys are breaking your neck to get to Switzerland and Canada and London. I'm not going to help nobody get something my Negroes don't have. If I'm going to die, I'll die now right here fighting you. If I'm going to die, you my enemy. My enemies are white people, not Viet Cong or Chinese or Japanese. You my opposer when I want freedom. You my opposer when I want justice. You my opposer when I want equality. You won't even stand up for me in America for my religious beliefs, and you want me to go somewhere and fight, but you won't even stand up for me here at home.
I don't have to be what you want me to be. I'm free to be what I want to be and think what I want to think, right?
You stand in the world as a heavyweight champion. And I'm not just going to be ordinary heavyweight champion. I'm going to be the greatest of all.
How are you going, John?
Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee.
Hey! Rumble, young man, rumble.
I was 4/100th of a second, which is an eye blink. Like a camera flash, that's 400th of a second. Now, the minute I hit Sonny Liston, all of those people blinked at that moment. That's why they didn't see the ball. I swear. And if you watch the film close, you gotta hold your eyes.
And every time we watch television, they show us Tarzan and the natives and the jungles. They never told us that the Africans were more intelligent than we are. They speak English. They speak English, French, and African. We can't even speak English good.
For all the white people, the critics, the world, had me ranked to go down. This was that man, and Allah, God was with me, and this man looked like nothing.
Right.
I want you to remember that. Want to know where I get the power? Visit your local Muslim mosque. Read that Muhammad Speaks newspaper.
Right.
Take it from me. I'm
that just proves you can have commercials on closed-circuit television just as you can have it on real television. Muhammad, what did you say to George?
That's not a commercial. No, telling people
to believe.
Believe in God. I'm going to float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. His hands can't hit what his eyes can't see.
Be nothing. Be too ugly to represent us color folks. These Africans think all of us ugly. Sucker, look at you. Hey, you out, sucker.
They said I can't. I was 240 at one time. They say he's fat. Look at me now. Don't tell me that ain't a perfect specimen of a man.
Go ahead.
Look at that body. Slim, trim, and on my toes. Oh, I'm on my toes now. I'm so sharp, when I'm finished, they look like I had a razor blade. I'm so bad, you know what I've been doing? Last week, I went out to the jungle. I wrestled with an alligator. I tussled with a whale. I done handcuffed lightning, throw thunder in jail. I'm bad, man. You know what I did last week?
No.
Last week, I murdered a rock. Into the stone, hospitalize a brick. I'm so mean, I make medicine sick. I'm fast. You know how fast I am? Fell, I'm so fast last week, I cut the light off in my bedroom, hit the switch, I was in the bed before the room was dark.
A magnificent tribute is paid to Muhammad Ali when he is invited to be the guest speaker at the graduating class of Harvard University.
I was told that it's a big honor to be invited to speak in a place like Harvard. I'm trying to be serious, but you want to make me laugh anyway. I understand that out of people such as you all come presidents and governors and mayors and great doctors and physicians and scientists and everything. So I said, well, to get something together to talk to these people, it's got to be pretty heavy. If you had told me I'd be offered a professorship to teach philosophy and poetry at Oxford and speaking at Harvard, man, I never would have believed it. So I'm real humble and I'm thankful to be here. It's such a high seat of learning, and I'm just a boxer when most boxers can't even talk. You couldn't invite Joe Frazier or George Foreman. This is the Ali Show. And this is
in the long and glorious history of Harvard University, no speaker ever received such a tumultuous standing ovation.
It's impossible, tell him. It's impossible.
Never lost a fight in your life.
Ask any of my fans when was the last time they lost. I'm too fast.
Champion for
the
grip.
King.
King
of the town. I'm not only a fighter, I'm a poet, I'm a prophet, I'm the resurrector, I'm the savior of the boxing world. If it wasn't for me, the game would be dead.
Now, give us that poetry on number 7. He wanted to go to heaven, so I took him to 7. You took him in 7. I am the king of the world.
Hold it.
I'm pretty.
You're not that pretty.
I'm a bad man. I took up the world.
I think so.
All right, tell us this. All right,